spot. Yeah.
Yeah, I think I do because I actually can't choose. I like the flowers that look like poppies from California, which looking
Okay.
over the Pacific Ocean, I'm from California, so
Yep.
that reminded me of that. And I love birds. So the birdhouses to me, I just really love those because I feed birds and I have birdhouses out. So that's one of the things I really love too. So I couldn't choose one. They're all cool.
This next piece, I think, is just adorable. And the price of $36.75, I thought was also extraordinarily reasonable for how sizable the piece is and how detailed it is. These are the Plow and Hearth Animal with two basket planters. I have two versions available. We had a third, our frogs are gone, okay? So we've got the dog that looks like a golden retriever, or we've got a bear. And
A
I've
bear.
always been in love with bears. I don't know why. I
Really?
think they're just the coolest animals. Now, the planters come empty, do they not?
They do.
Okay.
Exactly.
So I've got
So
some
they're
faux greens in mind, but they're equal to what would be a 6-inch pot.
Exactly. So what you've got are two containers that you can plant right in if you'd like. If you do, there are no drain holes. So I would suggest filling that with some pebbles or something in there just to kind of elevate so that the soil doesn't pack down. It also goes all the way through. Let me see if you can see this.
Yep.
So see, it goes all the way through. So you're going to fill that with soil, or you're going to be able to just take a plant and drop it right in.
Yeah.
So, you can do that. I only have one right there, but you get the idea. So you're going to be able to put these outside. These are made out of resin, and they are made out of cement, sort of a resin and cement blend, which makes them super durable. You've got great detail on them. I love that this bear just kind of looks like he's trying to figure out, is there honey in these logs? Do I need to go in there and get them? But then our dog looks like you said, a golden retriever, maybe a yellow lab. And we've got them planted with primroses here, but again, we just kind of drop them right in. It's super easy to just drop a plant in there, or you can plant in and put this out in your garden. Put it out on those front steps. Put them wherever you want to see that really fun little look, because again, we want to showcase those plants that you're getting from Roberta's and Cottage Farms and Philip Watson. You want to give them a showcase, not just a plain pot. Put
Yeah.
them in somewhere that you're going to be able to see from inside, because that's how you're going to enjoy them.
In the bear, there's now less than 200 of them remaining. In the puppy dog, there's twice that, about 400 remaining. And the frog that we saw in the video is gone. So it takes, and this is not unwarranted or unreasonable, it feels like forever to get pieces like this back on the air. Because they have to create the mold, they have to be cast, the mold then has to be released, these pieces then have to be individually painted, one by one by one. And look at the detail work.
Yeah,
Look at
I
what this
know.
looks like, real stonework with the
It
way they
does, yeah.
painted it. Nice touch, but that doesn't happen overnight. And today, by the way, is the very first day that these have ever been presented with four easy pay payments. And I don't know that Thursday, when we have our big home and garden event, if we even have inventory left, if they'll be on four easy pay payments. So
Right.
think about your favorite flowers and planting them side by side with a puppy bear, a puppy or a bear. And that's what we get to
Right.
do.
So cute. Really adorable. And these are really three-dimensional. You're looking at the texture of the bear. Look at the texture of his fur, his darling eyes. Again, I've mentioned so many times that Plow and Hearth does animals so well. The twinkle in their eye. You've got just the perfect coloration here. Like you said, that's hand-painted. These are textured. These containers are not just painted to look like that. That's
Yeah.
not just, like
Yeah.
illustration on there. That's real texture. The wood right here for the trunk, that's textured right there. So you've got really great detail and design. I love the little whimsy of his face. He kind of looks like he's thinking a little bit. Look at his little paws, kind of like curved up right there. They're so adorable. They're going to bring a smile to your face, but I love that they're a functional planter. So this right here, we've got our primroses just dropped right in there. But if you wanted to plant, you certainly could do that. I've just dropped a little plant in there. And look at how darling this is. In fact, last year at the beginning of when Pennsylvania was shut down,
Yep.
I took this little guy and I put them out by my mailbox because I wanted, people were walking in the neighborhood and they just needed something cute to look at. So I planted them with spring flowers. I believe it was Johnny Jump Ups. And then in the summer I put a marigold in, and then in the fall I put on mums. This guy sat out by my mailbox all the way until we had our first snow.
That's nice. You know, a bill to ship to is such an easy way to present someone with a gift that touches them. They don't need to know how inexpensive it was at $36.75. When they see the hand painting work, they'll assume it was more. Mm-hmm. You'll get the bill, they'll receive the gift, and you'll make them smile. Like this, that I still believe is one of the coolest things I've seen from Plow and Hearth in a long time. Plow and Hearth has been doing wall art for as long as I remember. And what made them different is they did wall art for outdoors. But think about this. How many of us have living rooms outdoors now with our patio furniture? I'll be showing you that coming up in just a bit. Brand new today.